In a major climb down, the center has offered to suspend the three contentious farm laws for up to 18 months in a bid to end the protest at Delhi's doorstep. Center also proposed to constitute a committee to review the laws and continue the ongoing dialogue with farm unions. The proposal came at a meeting between farm unions and the center yesterday after 9 rounds of talks failed to resolve the deadlock. Farm unions, however, told the government they will respond on Thursday, that is today, after discussing the proposal. The next meeting is scheduled on 22nd January. The government is ready to suspend the three laws for 1 to 1.5 years, during which a solution can be reached by mutual dialogue. We want the agitation to end and the talks with farmer unions to continue, Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar said after the meeting. Bharatiya Kisan Union Ugrahan President Joginder Singh Ugrahan said, "We rejected the proposal, but since it has come from the government, we will meet tomorrow and deliberate over it." The government has offered to suspend the implementation of the three laws for up to 18 months or a mutually agreeable period of time to restore the trust of farm unions, and they are willing to do this through an affidavit in the Supreme Court, said K. Kuruganti, who is part of the 41-member delegation of Samyukta Kisan Morcha negotiating with the government. The government has also proposed to form a committee to decide on the future of these laws, on whether they will be repealed or amended. "We will send a response in a day," Kuruganti said. Meghalaya, Manipur and Tripura celebrate their statehood day today. President, Vice President and Prime Minister have greeted the people of Meghalaya, Manipur and Tripura on the occasion of their statehood day today. In his message, President Ramnath Kovind said, "Blessed with immense natural beauty, rich history and vibrant culture, these states are fascinating." He extended his warm wishes as they continue to move ahead on the path of multifaceted development. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu said, "These northeastern states have retained their special place in India and have shown the way to the rest of the country through their natural diet and healthy lifestyles." He added that the three states have come a long way since their state formation, making India proud in every field. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said, "The culture and warm-hearted nature of the people of Tripura is admired across India. The state has achieved outstanding progress in various fields." He said, "India is proud of Manipur's contribution to national development. Manipur is a powerhouse of innovation and sporting talent." Mr. Modi said Meghalaya is known for its remarkable kindness and spirit of brotherhood. "Youngsters from Meghalaya are creative and enterprising," the Prime Minister said. Nagaland Chief Minister Ni Peurio today inaugurated the Recreational Center at Green Park in Dimapur. Chief Minister Rio, while congratulating the Horticulture Department for the initiative and hard work, said that the park will be a catalyst for economic activity and employment and preserved for future generations while meeting the needs of the present generation. Commissioner and Secretary, Horticulture Department Anandla T. Sato gave the welcome address, while Mission Director MIDH Dr. R. Elitang Lotha delivered a special note. Advisor Horticulture and Border Affairs Mathang Yanthan delivered a brief speech. Horticulture Officer and Officer in Charge SNH Dimapur Alam Tamsir gave the vote of thanks for the inauguration ceremony.
The Green Park, which is in the State Horticulture Nursery, is now upgraded with facilities like walking path or jogging path, and also with open gym facilities. Open gym equipments are there, and we have a lot of gazebos and pergolas created, and very soon the restaurant also will be coming up.
Karbi Anglong police recovered a rhino horn and arrested a person from the Dilai area of Bokajan in East Karbi Anglong yesterday. As reported, a team of Karbi Anglong police, based on specific information regarding dealing of a rhino horn at Dilai area, carried out an operation and recovered one rhino horn weighing around 390 grams from the possession of one Arif Jakaria, a resident of Tinsukia village under Juria police station in Nogao district. During preliminary interrogation, it was revealed that the horn was supposed to be sold in Dimapur. It needs to be mentioned here that there has been a recent spike in smuggling of animal parts in Bokajan subdivision of Karbi Anglong district, which is contiguous to Kaziranga National Park. Recently, Karbi Anglong police have arrested three members of a seven-member rhino poacher ring involved in the poaching of a rhino at Agora Toli Range of Kaziranga National Park. Like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for news that matters and stories that inspire.